It's the me, me, me lifestyle, and never before has a generation consumed as much as Gen Y. But nearly 2 years since the GFC hit, has Gen Y learned its lesson?
There's more sort of staying at home with friends and enjoying the company of friends, yeah, more in a close-knit environment.
Kim Stephen is a 24-year-old Melbourne DJ. He proudly represents Gen Y. But while he and his mates might be reducing their excessive spending, it's more about rebelling against globalisation, living in the times.
I wouldn't say major lifestyle changes, no. A major lifestyle change might be moving back home with your parents or something like that, and I haven't heard of anything like that happening.
There are 4 million young adults in Australia, and within 10 years they'll be the biggest consumer group. And that will worry some because Gen Y is spending less on music, watching a fifth less TV each week. When it comes to fashion, brand loyalty is declining.
We've seen them, you know, from a fashion perspective, we've seen them adopting sewing classes as a means to buying clothes that have pre-existed, like vintage clothing, and we've seen them then amend it and customise it to make it their own.
So people are reverting to back to what they know and what feels comfortable and safe, whether that be music from the 60s or 70s or what your parents might have listened to.
The perception of Gen Y as Facebook-addicted blog-writing Twitters is inaccurate because with less money to spend, they're spending more time outdoors.
I think there's more of a change to be sort of social and a little bit more active and do things outdoors.
They're certainly not bulletproof to the global financial crisis, so we've seen them really have to adapt their spending a little bit and become a little bit smarter about the way they spend their money.
Let's face it, it's just human nature that every generation likes to complain about the one before them. But while there were so many predictions that this global financial crisis would wipe out Generation Y, it hasn't actually been that bad. Sure, they may be shifting their habits, spending less in some cases, but really, they're just going back to basics.
It's not that bad for us. I think it's what we make of it. There are job opportunities out there. I guess we just have to look a bit harder these days and save a few more pennies, tighten the belt.
Overall spending across travel, entertainment, sport, fashion and music has decreased by $5 billion to $42.4 billion.
But it is just a slight shift. It doesn't seem to be that bad.
Well, if you sort of measured it up against the total economy, it wouldn't see, I think everybody would be quite envious of the shift in spend in the younger demographic.
And as for the GFC, well, this too shall pass.
I think the younger generation can pull through.
Aaron Young, Business Channel, Melbourne. Aaron Young, Sky News, Melbourne.